This is Patrick with New Jersey's Outdoor Adventures YouTube channel here at the first annual Tiny House Show in Augusta, New Jersey. And this is Mike here, and he's going to give us a tour of his bus conversion. What do we have here?
I got a 04 Thomas Freightliner that I converted. It's 35 feet long from nose to end, and I kind of completely gutted the thing and rebuilt it from the frame back, so yeah. Want to go inside?
Yeah, how long did that take you?
It took me about 9 months.
Wow. And is this just for show, or are you actually living in it?
No, I just moved in the last week, actually. The show was my deadline to finish. So I did that as like a deadline. Otherwise, I would just keep kind of building and building and tinkering. So.
Wow, this is actually very spacious inside. And the ceiling height, I would say this is about, what, 6.5, 7 foot?
It's 6'4".
6'4"?
Yeah, I got it there because one of my best friends is 6'3", so I wanted him to kind of feel comfortable in my home. So, yeah, it's actually just 6'4". So some of the tall people just stand in the skylights.
Okay, so yeah. I see you cut a hole in the roof, and what'd you do, just put some Lexan on top of it?
Yeah, so I built these with just like a strong plexiglass so that they don't break if there's like hailing or something or any type of weather. And yeah, I cut them out of the emergency exits, and then I added one in the middle because I wanted one in the kitchen.
It really does open up the floor plan quite a bit. And this is I guess a 96 inch wide, 8 foot wide bus?
Yeah, 7'6".
7'6".
Yeah, 7'6", and then from the driver's seat to the back wall is about 24.
Okay.
And then behind the wall, there's actually a garage, I like to call it, because it's not a trunk, because it's my home, so it's a garage. And it's got all my utilities, my solar hookup, and my water heater and all that kind of stuff.
And then you actually went ahead and did some really nice curtain design. Is that something you did?
Yeah, the whole thing was built by me and my dad. And like I said, it took us 9 months, so like everything was just kind of built from the ground up. I tried to use as many reclaimed materials, like the countertops I built. I found them on the, like, I found 4x4s on the side of the road, and I, you know, got them all, you know, cut and sanded, and kind of just made them custom for the bus. So they were all actually pretty much free, because it was just, you know, wood on the side of the road that I picked up. So it took a long time to do that kind of stuff, but it was worth it. You know.
I like these lamps that you made out of piping.
Yeah, just kind of bought some pipes and threw them together because it was cheaper than buying, you know, lighting and stuff.
And then the cab area here up front, it's just a regular school bus.
Yeah, essentially, I did rewire a bit of the dash. I got interior LEDs that are wired into the dash. I got a backup camera that I wired in full time for that.
It's got an automatic transmission.
Yep, automatic transmission.
And do you know what the powertrain is?
Yeah, the engine's a Mercedes, the transmission's an Allison, and I just put in a Rockwell differential.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, I switched out the differential.
And this is just some protection?
Yeah, this is actually a home forged knife. My friend made this. He gave it to me as a housewarming gift. This used to be a lawnmower blade, and this was actually my grandfather's antler that he killed a deer a long time ago, and I found his antler when we were cleaning out his house. And my friend made this as a housewarming gift.
And the holder he made too?
Yep, yeah, he made this for me too.
Wow.
So
that's really cool.
He picked the spot. He was like, I want it right there.
Right there. That's what you need.
Yeah.
This ceiling material, this is some type of pine, tongue and groove?
It's a white cedar, yeah, tongue and groove.
White cedar?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, I could smell it.
Yeah, the whole bus is white cedar except for the molding's pine and the countertops are pine.
And this would be like the control box for the bus?
No, this is actually, I rebuilt this upper section here. Hope I grabbed the right key.
It's all right.
Gotta love these universal keys, right?
There's lots of keys with RVs.
Yeah, right? I wish I could just make them all the same. But yeah, it's just a storage box.
Oh, wow.
And then I also built in surround sound into the head.
Okay.
And I did that because behind these are the windshield wiper motors.
Gotcha.
So you can pull these out and get to the mechanics if I need them.
If you ever needed to.
Because I used to just reach in from here.
And this is some type of laminate floor?
Yeah, it's
peel and stick type?
No, it's actually an engineered hardwood.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it is a click board, but yeah, I went with that because I wanted a little bit more, you know, weather working, so.
And then this down hinged here, piece here this, looks interesting.
There's a table under here.
Really?
So yeah, all the couches, the couch you're sitting on right now, they all fold out the beds. And then there's a table in here that comes out and pops up so I can have like dining for eight and have friends over and stuff like that.
Okay, so instead of using the standard sockets in the floor or the screw-in sockets, you actually made something that swings up.
Yes, it pulls out and swings up. And it's also the bed support, so it's a half clicks and then full clicks.
So this is about, this is bigger than a king-size bed when this folds out.
Yeah, it's actually 40 square feet, so you can fold out one of them or you can fold out both of them. So it's kind of like how many people are coming over and hanging out.
And then the material here it looks pretty durable.
Yeah, I got a pretty durable material because I wanted it to last. These were the only thing I didn't do on the bus. A local guy actually did it for me. He helped me design and cut them so I can make them fit for what I need. So he was really cool about that.
And the foam density is really nice and comfortable too.
Yeah, because these are also they're beds, so I wanted to make sure that was done right.
And then you have some type of home theater system.
Yeah, I don't own a TV, but I figured if I ever did, I wanted to have all the hookups for it. I just use a laptop, but and this is kind of just for kind of like use. I do have a projector that sometimes we play on the side of the bus and we can hook in.
Okay.
So yeah, sometimes we have like friends over at campground.
And then you made it into the newspaper.
Yeah, my friend wrote this article in Jersey, and she wrote an article about me and about the Tiny Homes Festival and just trying to raise awareness about, what we're at, what we're doing, what we're about, kind of thing.
That's excellent. And I see a lot of in the next 5 years, a lot of the RVs are going to be marketed towards millennials, and you'll see televisions actually not in them anymore.
Yeah.
Airstream launched a new product called Airstream Basecamp, targeted towards Generation X and millennials. There's no television inside.
Yeah.
So that's the direction that they're going to be going. Yeah. You can do portable electronic devices
for TV now. Everything in here is on Bluetooth, and I wired it with USB ports and plugs and everything just because they're there.
I like the choice of color in the cabinets. Are these upcycled or
No. So some of them are built and some of them were actually just pre-made cabinets. I just used the boxes and then just kind of rebuilt the doors to the look I wanted. And then like this.
Can I open one of them?
Yeah. There's just kind of like, I just moved in. So
he's got full extension.
Yeah, full. It's built to a house size. Everything's house size. So.
Yep. Very nice construction here.
Yeah, and then this one we custom built into the corner. So like this one kind of fit. I wanted this curb to kind of flow the bus down. So this one was custom built back here.
Well, in case you're wondering why there's cereal, I actually interrupted him during his breakfast, so he put it away. So don't think he's crazy for having cereal in the drawer. And then I see you have a residential stainless steel deep sink.
Yeah.
And residential faucet. So this has a high duty cycle. It's not like your typical RV faucet. Yeah. It's made out of plastic that's going to only last you a couple seasons.
Yeah.
The upper roof lockers are very, very interesting the way you designed them. Mm-hmm. They're actually they feel like they, it's part of the bus. It's not like like you just bolted a cabinet up there.
Yeah. You
scribed it to the wood.
Yeah, and it's screwed up into the frame of the bus. So it's in there.
I just love, the countertops we talked about earlier. I just love the way they look, the way they feel.
Yeah.
And they look they're going to be very durable for everyday use.
Yeah, I hope so.
And then you have, this is a residential type light switch. So this is anything on this bus run on 12 volt, RV?
Yeah. So this bus is completely off the grid. I've been running on solar for 4 weeks now.
Okay.
And it's run with 120 and 12 volt systems.
How much solar do you have?
I got three 120 panels.
Nice.
And I'm running a 3000 watt inverter.
And battery banks? What do you have for battery?
I have four 6 volt deep cells.
Okay.
They're essentially just, golf cart battery style.
Gotcha.
And they're wired in series in the back, which I can show you.
And then you have an RV air conditioner. This is like a 15,000 BTU Dometic.
Yep.
And this has electric heat strip.
No, it doesn't. I have a furnace, actually.
You have a four-set air propane furnace?
Yeah, it's right here. It's the intake's right down there. And it pushes out right here, and it's built into this cabinet.
Mm-hmm.
And then this face is removable to access it, and I need to pull it out.
Gotcha.
And that's vented out of the side of the bus.
And what are you doing for domestic hot water?
I got a hot water heater.
RV type?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's an instant hot water heater. It pumps from the pump, sends it all the way back to the garage, pumps it through the water heater, and then goes into my shower and the sink.
And then that is gas and electric, or just gas and
electric? It's all propane, And it's on a battery, a 12-volt, just a little battery kickstart.
A residential range. And this is quite unique because for a lot of people that really like to cook in their RVs, most of the RV appliances are very small. You went big on this. Yeah. You must like to cook.
I do like to cook, but I also did it just because it was cheaper.
It is.
You know, the small appliances were really expensive for me when I was trying to keep a budget low. So I just decided I like to cook. I wanted to build a good kitchen, and I haven't even used the oven.
Yeah, well, the manuals are still in. Now keep in mind, he just finished this.
Yeah, I just finished this thing. I just moved
in. And now he's had over a couple thousand people come over the course of Friday, Saturday, and today, Sunday. We just opened. No one's in here yet. Mm-hmm. But there will be a line. Yeah. You know, you could see the field and the fairgrounds here. There'll be a line of people waiting to get in this in just a little bit. And then what is this, some type of pantry?
Pantry. This is kind of just built, it's actually the wheel wells kind of hidden in this kind of space.
You always have to address the wheel wells when you're building some type of bus or RV conversion.
I had to rebuild the whole wheel well that was all rusted out, so I actually have re-undercoated the bus and rebuilt the wheel wells. Because I had, and then we built this kind of structure to kind of hide it into the closets.
Gotcha, and you have your thermostat control.
Yep.
And he's built it to code.
He
did put the carbon dioxide smoke detectors in. A residential refrigerator. This plugs into a regular electrical outlet. It runs off the inverter.
Yep, it runs off the inverter. It's I think it's a 6-amp draw and open, and then it runs on a 3-amp continuous. So what I usually do is during the festival, it's been kind of hard because people keep opening the door.
Sure.
But usually I just open it like 4 or 5 times a day, be real efficient about it, and it you know, I'm fine.
It's a nervous habit for people at RV shows to open refrigerators. I just see it all the time.
Yeah, and I've been.
Big though. This has to be an 18 cubic foot. I'm guessing.
I don't exactly remember, but it is big.
Yeah, it's bigger than your 7 cubic foot you have.
The bus curves. Mm-hmm. So what I did was I measured to fit this, and I kind of just got the highest one I could because I built the closet.
Yeah.
So I figured why not just kind of match it.
See the curvature of the bus here. You know, he couldn't slide it up against the wall. If it was a taller refrigerator, he would lose his aisle space. Yeah. So he found one that went right up to the curve.
Yeah.
All right, and then we have, I guess, some type of bathroom.
Yeah, bathroom, so we can come on in here. It's on the double doors. And this is
just regular shelving material you buy at the home center.
Yeah, I just grabbed it and kind of re-sanded it, you know, made it real fine and polyed it and stuff.
And he has the safety catches on it. You know, when you're driving on the highway, you don't want these doors to fly open.
No. Yeah, first time we drove this thing, actually, we didn't lock the fridge in.
Yeah.
And the fridge went flying.
Yeah, that could be hazardous. And then this shower pan is a residential type.
Yep.
And then you did some mini subway tile with a gray grout.
Yep.
And I actually, see how the window is done? That's pretty neat stuff.
Yeah. I used the small tile because I used...
Flexible
grout. So the more grout I had, I figured would help me with the vibration. So I went with a small tile and more grout to kind of help make sure that the tiles didn't crack on me or anything like that.
And this is some type of composting toilet?
Yeah, just a typical Nature's Head composting toilet.
And how's that working out for you?
Working good. I haven't really used it too much just because I've been at the fairgrounds and, you know, as you said, I just moved in. So, and I got a curtain here for the door. Everything's polyed and sealed, but I have a curtain for just extra protection.
Very familiar with this curtain. We see a lot of different RVs, too.
Yeah, it's just a, you know, water barrier.
If you want to find an excellent video on composting toilets and RVs, there's a couple on YouTube, Fit RV, and they did a great review on a composting toilet. The ins and outs of it, it's definitely something worthwhile if you're considering putting one in an RV. All right, now across the hall here we have some type of cabinet, but I see I have it locked.
Yeah, just because this is
all your stuff.
Yeah, this is all my stuff. I haven't moved in a lot of my stuff because I knew I was coming to the fairgrounds, so I kind of just stuffed all my stuff in here, and I'll go back to actually my parents' house and pick up the rest of my stuff after the show.
Yeah.
But yeah, same design as the first closet.
You're going to inspire a lot of our viewers to do something similar to this.
Yeah.
On a budget, how much does something like this cost to do? I mean, you did it right.
Yeah, so actually I did all the work with myself, with my dad, and some friends who were helping. We actually just spent just over $20,000, including buying the bus. We got the bus really cheap because it had a lot of engine issues, a lot of rust issues. And we just spent like 2 months just doing engine and rust remediation. And then we just started building back from there. So the bus now is like, you know, pretty solid, no rust kind of problems. But, you know, I got it. That's where the budget came from. I tried to keep it lean.
And then back here, this could be another bed.
This is my bedroom, essentially. I set it up as a couch right now just for the show. Mm-hmm. But this folds out into a bigger than a full-size bed. This whole area just kind of becomes a bed.
And this is accessible outside?
No, it's just storage.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, all the beds have storage. They all flip out to beds.
And you use, cedar in there?
Birch? Yeah, it's just kind of like a thin material, kind of cabinet material.
And this is all part of the bed mechanism. Yeah. There's a bar that comes across here.
Yeah, there's a bar in here.
Okay.
So this bar, I just made a lock system. Okay, yeah, it goes that way. And that keeps it so that when I wake up in the morning, I can sit in the hallway, not break the bed.
That's excellent.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah, I just leave it there. And then, yeah, this thing folds out. And then up here, I got upper cabinets, which is above the garage I was talking about. So up here is just more storage. I'm not too sure what I'm going to use it for, but I just built it because I thought, why not? And I figured that in the garage, height room would be a waste of space because you can't really stack things that high. So I figured I'll cut the garage in half and then use this as in-cabin storage.
Wow. And is there a generator on board?
There's not currently because I've been running on solar, but I have a rack on the outside that I'm going to be mounting one up
into. So you prepped it for generator?
Yeah, I prepped it all for generator.
And can you take us around the outside here?
Yeah, sure.
Look at this, we got a line already.
Thanks. Yeah, so out here we got a table, which kind of folds down.
This is pretty heavy duty. You got chains on here. So you could put a good amount of weight on there. You could put a grill if you wanted
to. Yeah, I weighted it for 220 pounds. So if I, give a good push on it, it's not going to snap on.
A lot of thought went into that. And this is some type of window, almost like a window hardware to lock it up.
Yeah, and I made it tight so it doesn't shake while I'm driving, because that's just annoying.
And then you went with a green paint. Is there a specific color they call that?
I think it's forest.
Forest green.
Forest wood green. And then I used cedar on the outside. I designed it after a craftsman styled home. So I tried to use like a lot of earth colors, cedar. And I just really like the design of those homes, so I wanted to say, hey, I'm going to build a bus with that design.
And I like the extra detail here on the side.
Yeah,
put these lag bolts in.
Yep. Yeah, we ripped off all the rub guards and kind of bondoed and sheet metal the side.
And this is some type of low point drain?
Yeah, so this is my air. I have 130 gallons under here, and this is my dump. This is my air, and then it's wired with my fill into these. This is my fresh water, my gray water's on the other side.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
And then wow, look at that exhaust.
Yeah, replace that guy.
And he did some undercoating as well.
Yeah, did a lot of work.
And this is your potable water fill?
Yep, this is the fill.
And then I guess type of spotlighting outside.
Yeah, I put floodlights around the whole outside so I can kind of light it up if I'm somewhere I need to.
Hey, you never know.
Yeah, and they're all wired into the front control panel. So they...
There's a line of folks here waiting to take a view of the bus.
Yeah. And then, these are just windows I blocked out for the closets that you saw inside. So they just, blocked those out.
And this would have been an accessory with the bus that you're probably not utilizing right now?
This is just a diesel.
Diesel. A diesel fill.
Yeah.
Okay. And is it both sides or just one side?
Just this side. And then I just put this rain guard on it because I was leaking water inside.
Okay.
And then these are my inputs. I am hooked up on solar. I can plug in for shore power. So this is my 30 amp switch. Mm-hmm. This actually goes directly to the AC because that can't run on solar.
Okay.
So if I plug this guy in, I can run the AC. I can plug this guy in, it will switch. And then this is my heater for my tank, my diesel.
Wow, look at this rack on the top. What's going on up there?
So it's an 8x10 deck. I built it because I just really wanted to use the roof space. So it's a good hangout spot. And I welded this ladder together. And we racked this ladder on the back that you can just climb up. And
wow, look at this heavy duty lock here for the back door.
Let me grab the key real quick for you.
Well, he's in there grabbing the key. This is the top piece here at the show. This is what everybody's talking about. You plan on doing more of these shows, or was just a one-off thing?
I live in Sussex County, and I built the bus up here. So I heard the show is going to be in Sussex County, and it does work for nonprofits and stuff. So I wanted to get the show for that reason. But after doing it, I do enjoy it, and I've met really cool people. So yeah, over here's my water heater.
Tankless water heater on this side. There's your big inverter.
Yeah, inverter, 120 panel.
3,000 watt.
Yep.
You got automatic transfer switch. And you went with the Go Power Solar.
Yeah, I didn't really understand solar, so I went with a company that I could call up and talk to.
Yeah.
But now that I've done it once, I mean...
You could do it again.
Yeah, I could do it again. Yeah, exactly.
So. No backup. Yeah, there is a backup camera.
Yeah, it's actually hardwired into the dash. So when I'm driving, I can have it on all the time. So I can see people are tailgating me or coming up behind me and stuff.
And where do you empty your waste?
Where or what?
Well, like, where's the discharge?
Oh, right here. Yeah, so this is my gray water tank. The discharge just comes out of the inlet valve. It's right here. Oh, right here. I'm a little too far. Right here. So
okay.
I just kind of flip that lever, and I can attach a hose to it because it's got threads. And then this is where I'm going to put the generator. I'm going to rack it up into these guys here. So I got to find one that's going to fit.
And you had to get a CDL license for this?
No, I got it re-registered with Jersey as a motorhome.
Good.
So I'm all legal as a motorhome.
That really makes life a little bit easier day to day.
Yeah, it wasn't easy to get, but it really helped with, you know, just, you know, what I'm doing here. So.
And we have access to the deck, or is that closed off today?
Oh, yeah, you can go up. Yeah, you can go up. I don't let people at the festival just for...
No, you'd have grandma fall off.
Yeah, exactly. But if you want to go up, I think you're good with heights, right? Yeah, you can climb on up.
You can hold that for a second.
Yeah, sure.
You can film me going up.
Yeah.
This is roof here. Just don't want to be too close to the little power line there.
Yeah.
So this is the deck here. This looks like it's about as wide. So we're 7.5 foot wide.
Yep.
And there's a little hatch here for the skylight. So if he has a party going on up here, no one falls through.
Yeah.
You can see the white coating on the roof. This actually reflects sunlight, keeps the interior temperature down about 7 degrees cooler than outside ambient. Mm-hmm. And there are his 120 watt solar panels. I like the rail system. You actually used gas piping. That's pretty structurally sound.
Yeah, and they're the deck and the solar are welded into plates that I put in between the ribs of the bus, and that's then so the weight of the deck is actually into the ribs, which then goes to the suspension. So the deck's actually not resting on the roof nor the solar panels. They're actually resting on the suspension of the bus. Which was, of course, important for just, you know, structure and everything.
Excellent. Well, I think we're going to wrap this up, this tour. He's got a whole line out there. This is Michael and Patrick with New Jersey's Outdoor Adventures YouTube channel. Hope you enjoyed this video. Please like this video, comment, share, subscribe. I'd love it. I'll see you soon. And do you have a Twitter or Instagram?
Yeah, I have an Instagram. It's at Navigation Nowhere.
So if you want to check out the build on there, I'm sure he's got some really cool pictures up.
Yeah.
Thanks for watching.
Thanks.